OK, I draw another random one. I don't know, this one. OK, let's assume this one. So I get that. So this is not fun, this one. This one is not fun. I will just add this one. OK, so I contract that. OK, now I have that. Yeah, there is a double edge here. So I don't know. I will just play up. Let's assume this one. So I'll get that. And then I contract any of these two. Say up. OK, and I have just one edge at the end. OK, so I have found the min cut. OK, so I was lucky here. For instance, if I did contract these two edges here, I would have got. So I could have imagined another execution here. But at that point, I would just contract this edge and then get this graph. And then contract this edge and then get this graph. And I would get a cut of size 2. OK? So this is one execution. So what we have here is that, for instance, the min cut we consider is this edge here, this simple edge. And clearly, the probability that we fail at the first step is 1 over 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1 over 6. OK? So now we need to estimate this ratio here. Because k, we don't know what it is. M, we don't know either. OK? So we need to estimate it. So can you just give a bound relating M and k? Can you just think about something?
K is always smaller than M over N?
Yep. K is always smaller than M over N. So we will try to make it right. It's almost true. OK, so why is it so? Because if you have a min cut of size k, what's going on if you just remove one node from the graph? OK, the simplest, the trivial cut. Let's assume that the trivial cut, is just you just put one node aside. OK, what can you say about its degree? What can you say about the degree of a node? Yep. Because, so let's assume that we will try to make it right afterwards, but the idea is that. Let's say that because that for all u, the degree of u has to be larger than k. Okay? Because simply, because, a lot of because, u, v minus u, is a cut of size degree of u. Okay? U, v of u, v minus u is simply a cut of size degree of u. So, since k is the size of a minimum cut, the degree of u is larger than k. But, as you know, m, 2m is the sum of the degree of u. And, as we've proved before, it's larger than k times n. OK? So 2m is larger than k than m. So let's move the 2 here. And there also. And there marker also. And what you get here is from that, is that the probability of failure is less than, than the probability of failure is k of, it's not 2 that I had to move. It was n. That was m that I wanted to move. OK. So we move n here. We move m here. And we get that the probability of failure is less than 2 over m. N. OK? So that's nice. It's 2 over n. And as I mentioned before, k can only increase when you contract edges. OK? But this inequality is independent of the value of k. OK? So the probability of failure at any step of the algorithm is always 2 over the current number of nodes. OK? So now what can I say? I can say the following. Is, so we have the lemma but we have just proven, okay, which is the following. At the ith step, the probability of success given that it did not, the success at the ith construction given that it did not contract any edges from the min cut in during the first I minus one contraction. Okay. So the probability that I'm not failing if I did not fail before is simply at most, at least, the probability of success is at least what? 1 minus the probability that I fail, given that I did not fail before. One minus n minus n plus one minus I. Okay, at step one, we've seen that the probability of failure is at most 2 to the n. Okay, and we see that it's true at any step. At the highest step, n equals n plus one minus I. So this probability is that. Okay, so we can rewrite it as n plus 1 minus I plus 2 minus 2 over n plus 1 minus I, which is simply n plus, in the sense of minus, n minus 1 minus I over n plus 1 minus I. Okay? So as you see, it's very close to 1 most of the time. Okay? The ratio is very, very close. You never get to zero. Okay? So now, what can I say? Now I want the probability, the overall probability of success of the algorithm. And the overall probability of success is simply the probability of success is equal to the probability that of success at the last is n minus 3 step, given, well, it's the probability that I did not fail at any step. Let's write it this way. But for all step I from 1 to n minus 3, was a success. Okay? So let's say AT is the event that step T is a success. Okay? I want all these steps to be a success. So the probability of success. Do you understand what I mean by event? Okay, it's the set of all the random strings that leads to a success. Okay, yeah, are you comfortable with probability or no? It's okay? Well, okay, so the probability of success is simply the probability of the of A1 and A2 up to AN minus 3. Okay, but you can rewrite it as the probability of a n minus 3, knowing that everything went fine up to a minus n minus 4, times the probability that everything went fine at step n minus 4, given that everything went fine before. up to n minus 5.